This is the IO plate right here. Now the one that usually comes with the cases are pretty standard. You usually have your PS2s here, USBs here. Recently they started coming with a LAN port up here, two serial ports, or if your video, or if your motherboard has onboard video, that's going to be your video. A parallel port, joystick port or MIDI port, and then your sound. Let's say that your motherboard doesn't have the punch-outs line up, but if that did happen, it's really quite simple. Typically, the motherboard comes with a new I.O. plate. I want to make sure I emphasize that. The motherboard comes with the I.O. plate. Now, taking this guy out, it's a real tight fit, but it's doable. This is a little spring steel ridge right here. And if you push really hard, you can get that thing to pop out. You have to push from the outside in. They do that because the replacement plate has to push from the inside out. And once the motherboard's in there and all of your ports are lined up with these holes, then of course the plate's not going to accidentally pop back in again because you have the motherboard back there. So before you put the board in, check to make sure your I.O. plate lines up. I'm going to grab my board here and you're going to see that my I.O. plate does line up. Okay. See there? The I.O. does line up. There's my motherboard. Okay. The only thing I'm going to need to do is I've got onboard LAN here, and as you can see, this is not popped out yet, so all I have to do that is just take my flathead screwdriver, stick it in the little slot they provide, and just push. It's just tack welded in there, so it's going to come right out. As soon as I pop that out, there we go. I'm all set to line that board up with that I.O. plate.